Yo, what's up guys, Felix from Giant Lifestyle. Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm sitting down with my buddy Joe. He is a full-time real estate investor and I'm gonna ask him a few questions about how he bought this house and fixed this house and now plans to sell this house, make a bunch of profit and literally not use $1 of his own money. So I'm gonna turn the camera around. I'm gonna ask him a bunch of questions. So if you guys wanna learn how he did this, maybe we'll get him to start some sort of channel and he will be able to show you what it looks like to be a real estate investor. So Joe, welcome to the channel, man. Hold on, let me get the camera right so everybody can see you. But come down a few steps for us so we can ask you a few questions.
Yeah,
but
for sure.
First off, tell everybody who you are and exactly like what do you have going on for us today?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm Joseph, real estate investor and developer.
And then as far as this deal, like how did you find this deal? Because I know some people say that it's hard to find deals. There's no properties out there. There's no deals for them. How did you go about doing and finding this deal that we have in front of us?
Before this video starts, I just want to remind you to check the first link in the description if you want to learn how to build a business buying and reselling diabetic medical commodities. The second link will give you information on how I built a business flipping pallets. The third link is if you want to learn how to become an independent courier. The fourth link is a book by my mentor in real estate, which will teach you how to flip houses using none of your own money. Check out the fifth link if you want to get 6 free stocks on Webull simply by opening up a brokerage account and depositing at least 1 penny. Below that is a link to my merchandise store where I sell t-shirts. If you like my content and want to show support, go ahead and pick something up.
Yes, absolutely. That's a great question. A lot of people are doing the wholesaling route and they're doing all this off-market marketing to people that own houses. For me, what's worked in my business, we actually get a lot of our deals via the MLS. I have an advantage because I have my own construction company as well, so we're fully vertically integrated. Another huge thing is we get a lot of deals from the relationships that we have from other wholesalers as well as other agents and brokers that we've established really good relationships with them. They know me for a while now and so I get first dibs on a lot of these deals.
Okay, now for somebody who might be wondering, and then just tell us real quick, what is the MLS for anybody that's watching this video, might be new to real estate and is still learning all the terminology. What is the MLS?
Yeah, so the MLS is just basically what the agents are using. They go in and they have access to all the properties that are on the market. You don't necessarily need to use the MLS. You could use Redfin, you could use Zillow. If you don't have access to the MLS and you really want access to the MLS, you could ask your agents as well. That's another tactic that you can do to just be on top of all the information, because you'll see if it's really under contract or not, and you won't waste your time looking at a deal that's not available on the market. Even though Redfin says it's available, you won't know unless you have access to the MLS.
Okay, I gotta turn the camera around for this question, but people might wanna know, like, are you really doing this deal with no money? You know, it's a kind of a cliche term or phrase to say, but like, how are you doing it and are you really using none of your own money?
Yeah, so absolutely zero money into this deal. And it's also how I started off with in real estate. Just even my first deal, partnered up with someone, second deal, borrowed money. So there's multiple ways you could do deals without your own money. And in fact, I highly suggest that you do if you want to build an actual business and do 5, 10, even 20, 50, 100 properties a year, whatever your goals are. You want to make sure that you know how to raise money, leverage the relationships that you have in order to bring in some money, some capital, and be able to do a lot more deals and make a business out of it. Otherwise, you'll do a deal maybe every once a year, which is no business, right? So you could also do it as a side hustle and use your own money, but why not use other people's money and go and do more deals? You get a great return, right? An infinite return if you use none of your own money. And your investors, they also make a great return. So you're providing a good for other people as well, not just yourself.
So basically, if I heard that right, the way you're able to do this is you're basically getting other people to put up their money and you're basically just managing the project, running the project, overseeing everything. And then how does it work as far as, can you give us a little bit of insight of how it works as far as, you know, making sure that they get, you know, their money secured, how you get it? Touch a little bit on that.
Yeah, absolutely. So there's two ways you could go on about it. You could partner with someone else and you could just give them a fixed return, right? And there's a lot of you have to consult with your attorney, but here's what I'll tell you, right? If you're doing a partnership, which is probably the primary way you will start if you don't have previous experience, once you get a lot of experience, you could go the other route, which is what I'm doing now for the most part. with a partnership, what you're gonna do is you're gonna just actually put them on a, you can make an LLC together. That's one way to do it, is multiple ways. You can make an LLC together, so you're 50-50 partner or 80-20 partner, whatever the operating agreement will say. And now you're both on a deed, you're both legal partners on a deal. So when the house sells, you're both gonna get paid out, okay? And then, but you will share in the profits and a loss. Once you get some more experience, you could start pitching people on just getting a fixed return. Now, what a fixed return is gonna look like is they're basically going to get a mortgage on the property. They're going to get a promissory note on the property. It could be first lien, second lien, kind of like what a bank does, right? So you're going to secure their investment via these documents and definitely set that up with your attorney. Pitching it that route, the pro is they will get a fixed return. Whether the deal goes north or south, they should be getting paid off no matter what, right? You should be putting your mouth where it counts. Now, regarding that aspect, the con is that they won't get as much of a return. I give my investors maybe a 12% return, could be as low as 10% return or an 8% return. I try to be a little bit generous sometimes and do 12%. It's a win for them. They don't have to worry about the profits and the loss of the properties, because some things can go a little bit south. If you don't know what you're doing, that's obviously the biggest risk. And they can sleep well at night. They don't have to worry about a single thing.
So you basically, they might get a little bit less, but they're basically completely hands off. But that also allows you to be completely money off, more or less, where you don't got to touch a single dollar of your own, but you raise the money from somebody else. Is that correct?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. You want to, as much as you can, you want to raise the money and go out and get the deals. You want to be the brains and the bronze, so to speak, and just have a money partner or a money lender or a set of money lenders, and just talk to a lot of people, build a list of people, maybe 50 to 100, or just start with 5 and 10 close friends. That's okay too, if you have close friends that have some money, a parent, or you know, a dad, a mom, an uncle, aunt, whatever it is. Go and just start talking to people and get some stock commitments. Say, hey, look, you know, I'm getting into a real estate investment business, or I'm in a real estate business. I've done some research and I have this deal. Here's what the numbers look like. Is this something you might even entertain in partnering up, or however way you want to structure it? And just kind of start some conversations with a bunch of people. Just a normal chat, nothing serious.
Got you. But even at worst case scenario, if that doesn't work, they can, with some money down of their own, go to a hard money lender. Is that correct? But I know the purpose of this video is how you're doing deals with literally no money, but that is possible, right? With hard money, if they want to put, you know, 10, 20, 30% down and get a hard money lender to put money up for the deal, correct?
Yeah, absolutely. Hard money lenders, they'll do 85 to 90% of the purchase price, depending on your experience. They'll give you 100% of the rehab. You just need around, even though it's technically 15% that you might need of the purchase price, you still need a good 20, 30% for everything that's going to be involved in getting the projects moving and the closing costs, and just going to have to fund the construction in the beginning as well.
Cool. So realistically, you know, give us, you know, the loan number. You know, I know the property, you know, I'm going to put some B-roll on this video so you can see what the property looks like inside, but tell the people how much you're going to make, like, in profit after your investor gets paid off. How much are you gonna put in your own pocket in profit? And keep in mind, he didn't use any of his own money to do this deal. How much are you actually gonna profit?
Yeah, so we're projecting, it's under contract, it's on the market rather. We're projecting around $60,000 with just, you know, within 3 to 4 months. That's how long we've been in it. I think maybe 5 months max. And by the time that we sell the property, it should be around 6 months in total. So it's not a bad return with none of your own money. You're completely leveraged. You're providing a great opportunity for other people, and that's how you should think about it, by the way, when you're investing, when you're pitching other people. You're literally providing an opportunity for someone else.
Cool. And then as far as the plan with the profits, what do you like plan to do with them? Are you gonna just take them for and go find another deal? Or are you gonna, you know, maybe buy a new car? Or what is your plan with the profits?
Yeah, well, definitely you wanna be a good steward of money. So when you make money, you wanna make sure that you're keeping it to run your business, expand your business, and be able to really, if you want to de-risk your business, you want to keep that money in your bank. You don't want to go spend a car, buy it on a Ferrari or a Lamborghini or go buy a house. Because then you're not a steward of, you're not a good steward of money, right? Because what happens if one deal goes south and you can't pay off your investor, right? So you keep that money in your bank for overhead, payroll, things that go south. It's really going to help you sleep well at night, because real estate can be incredibly stressful, and having that kind of that cushion in the bank really, really helps. And when you have that money, you don't go and use it for another property. What you do is you keep that money in your bank. You need that to stay safe in this business, believe me. And then you go and you raise more money for other deals, thereby just continuing the cycle, and you provide a good opportunity for other people to make money as well.
And did you say, I might have had a brain fart, did you say how much you think you're gonna make on this deal?
Around 60 grand.
60,000. 60,000 profit, none of your own money being touched.
Absolutely.
And then two more questions and then we'll wrap this video up. Some of the worst things that could happen, what can people expect? Like, obviously it's not all sunshine and rainbows. What is some of the worst things that people can expect possibly? And I know you have a bunch of deals going on, but something that people can expect, what can they expect the worst thing to happen from something like this, you know, doing these type of deals?
Yeah, well, there's a lot of things that go wrong. So absolutely you need to get educated, have a mentor, or get a really, really good deal and do a lot, tons and tons of due diligence. There's a lot of, you know, free material out there. There's paid materials. You could go on Bigger Pockets. There's tons of videos on YouTube, and there's a lot of paid services that you can do. There's a lot of things that can go wrong. God forbid a general contractor walks away with your deposit, which, by the way, if you're a professional investor, you should not be putting down large deposits. You know, I've heard of people, you say, putting 50% deposit, say they put a $50,000 deposit, contractor walks away. That's the absolute worst thing that could happen. Another thing is you don't do proper due diligence, you didn't do an inspection on the property, or there's some hidden problems. Even though an inspector did his inspection, there could be hidden problems behind the walls. Now you have electrical, plumbing issues, and other issues that you may have not noticed, and you're down maybe 20 to 30 grand or whatever the case may be. And so if you're not an expert in the real estate industry, you want to make sure you have a really good deal for potential things that can go south, or maybe the market will take go a little bit south and the house will take a little bit longer to sell than you perceive, or you have to reduce the price. The most common mistake is people don't know how to run their numbers. And so what they will do is they'll say, hey, I'm buying this house for $200,000 and it's worth $300,000. I'm gonna put $60,000 into the deal. I should walk away with money, right? And they don't know how to do the numbers. And so what actually happens is they will lose money because there's tons of costs that they didn't calculate that goes into the deal. And finally, not getting the proper ARV, the after repair value. They will go and they will underwrite a deal. They will say, hey, there's a house 0.5 miles away that sold for $450. And maybe has a different number of bathrooms, bedrooms, the neighborhood is different, it has a driveway, yours doesn't have a driveway. There's a lot of nuances that you don't know about and you didn't underwrite the deal properly. And appraisers don't necessarily know more than you, right? They can actually potentially get it wrong if they don't know the market too well, or depends on a number of factors. So you need to know your numbers.
Okay, and then the last thing, just to wrap this video up, any final thoughts on somebody who wants to do this? There's a lot of people who are gonna see this video, people who wanna get into this, any words of encouragement or anything they need to know?
Well, I'll start, the first words of encouragement I can give you is I'll start by saying it's tough, right? It's tough to start in, and so you shouldn't walk away from the business after you have these trials. That's the best words of encouragement that I can give you, is expect it to be tough and then keep pushing through it. Okay, if you have a full-time job, keep your full-time job. It's gonna be very slow in the beginning, right? It's not a fast-term business. You're gonna buy a property, it's gonna take 6 to 12 months to flip it, and then you don't have any money. If you use your own money, you don't have any money to pursue another project, or if you haven't raised money for a second, third project, you don't have much to do, right? So keep your full-time job. Stay persistent, because it's going to be tough and it's worth it. Real estate has made the most number of millionaires in this world, right? Nothing else matches it.
Cool.
In terms of safety, in terms of the leverage. If you're buying a stock, you could lose money. If you're buying real estate, you know you're gonna make money if you have the right information. you have the right access to information, you underwrote your property good enough, and you're actually experienced, you're not going to lose money.
Cool.
And there's nothing that will make you a millionaire, just like real estate, with the amount of certainty that it can actually help you make money.
Cool, cool. Well, there you guys have it. We're gonna wrap this video up here. Be sure to subscribe. Let Joe know how he did on the camera. First video that he's made in a while. Again, thank you guys for watching. Hit the thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't, and we'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.